travaille avec Mathieu Montalban from University of Bordeaux. We work in Bordeaux on the Work Bucket 5, which was not really dedicated to venture capital. It was much more based on corporate governance and innovation. But we have made some works on VC and on industrial policy too. So I will try to summarize some of the main findings of the Work Package 5, and we'll see that it is very complementary from what Andrea said to you. First, to what was the main topic of Work Package 5, it was much more dedicated to corporate governance, industrial strategy, business models, and shareholder value distribution, typically. So the type of work that Bill Lazonik presented you this morning. On VC, VC funding are largely considered by, I would say, belief that it is one of the most important source of funding for small and medium-sized enterprise and young innovative enterprise. And a lot of policies are trying to develop VC and then support innovation. In Work Package 5, we developed some studies that respond for two main questions relative to VC. The first, VC funds impatient investor. So this is a type of work done by Bill Lazonik. And the relative role of state to have a stable investor to fund innovation. So this problematic has been raised through different papers from Bill Lazonik, Erdem Sekinch, Anna Tulum, Andres Cardenas, and myself. And the second problematic deals with the unequal development of private equity in VC across country, with a specific focus on Europe. So this is typically in the same line of Andrea. So, of course, in 20 minutes, I won't have the time to go in detail in all this work. So I will select the main findings of each study. Sorry. So first, VC have impatient and financialized investors. This question has been well thought with the work of Bill on the US industry, especially in pharma, ICT sectors, and clean industry. So I will present the pharma case because I know very well pharma, much more than the other, and if you have any questions for the other sectors, you can ask, and I suppose that Bill will respond in the minutes. So, a widespread idea in the US biotech sector has been the idea that this is VC funding that explains the development of biotech and bio and pharmaceutical industry. What we have shown in this work is in fact that there's a lot of investment from states, US federal state, through the NIH, and a lot of policies to implement development of biotech industry, with, for example, the orphan drugs regulation, which has been mimicked at the European level, and which have boosted a lot of the biotech industry. I give you some ideas, which is a work from Bill Lazonik on the finance and the funding of the NIH, and the NIH, you know, is funding a lot of work for biotech industry. Another idea is the fact that more and more VC funds are becoming impatient, and which has been raised with the question of productless biotech. A lot of biotech firms have no product and they become public through IPO. But by the time, it becomes more and more difficult for this company to be funding because they are obliged to make a lot of share repurchase and not able to write money from the stock market. So I will skip this point and I will go from another work based on a comparative study on on industrial policy, which is work done by Andres Cardenas, Erlen Fakinch, and myself. So we made a study about the industrial policy in Germany, France, and UK. If we are if you are looking, for example, this question is interesting because we have very different type of VC funding and investment development in this country. This is not the same level. We have a lack of VC funding if we are looking at the stats for France or Germany, typically. But what is very interesting is the fact that, for example, France at the beginning of the 70s was really invest directly to develop pharma industry. For example, Sanofi Aventis was at the beginning a state-owned company, it was not private. And in the 80s and the 90s, the investment in biotech were declining from the state, not really very efficient. But if you are looking at the UK policy, we made interviews, so it was really funny. We found people from Switzerland, from the business office, who tell us that the policy of the UK government is a Colbertist English policy, typically. And for example, what is interesting is in the 90s, they developed the Pharma Task Force, which is to develop the pharmaceutical and biotech industry. And from a long period of time, you've got the policy of the pricing system that supports the reward for innovation. From the French and German point of view, the policy has changed in the 90s and in the 2000 for France. And in France, we have now an important role of government to support biotech industry through a very large, different type of tools. Typically, we've got tax credit on R&D, which is not very efficient in my view. You've got a sort of sovereign fund, which is called sovereign fund, typically which invests directly in a company. And a lot of collaboration between the regional policies and some clusters. And the result was not so bad in the recent year because there's an increase of the number of funding from VC and the number of companies which becomes public. So you have got some stats about the venture capital, what the same things that they are. This is for France, typically. But if you are looking at the numbers for the biotech industry, as you see, UK is still dominant. And this is some type of stats. I will go back after. But what can explain the slow development of biotech industry in France, for example, or in Germany compared to UK? What is very interesting is the fact that R&D expenditure in France decreased during the last 15 years. So it explains a lot of the slowdown of the industry at the industry level. So I will skip to the second question. I try to be brief. So this is a completely different question, which is about the explanation of the unequal development of private equity industry in Europe. European Venture Capital Association is lobbying countries and government to change fiscal and legal environment to favor venture capital markets. So we had a question with a PhD student in private equity, which was about how can we explain such a heterogeneous development of this industry. If we want to summarize, we have two types of theory that can explain this unequal development. The first one is a much more mainstream theory, which is called legal origin theory or law and finance theory, which is the same thing. And the second one is much more heterodox, I would say, which is variety and diversity of capital. Legal origin theory approach developed by Laporta, Lopez, Danes, Schreiber, and Vichny explains financial development and institutional change by the legal origin of the system, economic system. So the main idea is to say that common law English systems are better to protect investors and creditors, which can explain the strong development of financial markets and venture capital markets, for example. So you've got it here, the taxonomy of the different legal systems, if you have much more questions, if I'm interested. The second explanation is from variety of capitalism literature, which is much more based on political factor and institutional complementarity between different institutional domains. So you've got the work, for example, from Bruno Amable, which made a taxonomy of different systems based on their institutional complementarity between the different institutional domains. So there's a debate between these two types of theory. One theory explains all the diversity of capitalism by just one cause, which is legal origin, and one other with a complex system of interaction between different institutions. You can summarize like this if you want. In the case of VC and legal origin, you got a lot of work from coming, for example, on the role of legal system and fiscal system on the development of VC. And most of the time they explain quite well why the VC industry is less developed in common law, in civil law countries. Sorry. You got also work on benchmarking to explain the extractiveness of European countries. So what we wanted to do is to explain, is to check if this is true, in fact. So we made an econometric work on this question. First of all, some differences between legal origin system and venture capital development. As you can see, UK first, it is on the left. But if you take Ireland, of course, it is very weak. And if you can French origin system, we have a very different type of level of investment in venture capital. We have a quite heterogeneous group. And German is much more clear to the same thing. And Scandinavian too. I briefly summarize the main results. So we made econometrics. So I will summarize this powerful table with words. We say. First of all, investor protection, which is the main indicator to explain development, financial development in legal origin theory, is quite higher in Anglo-Saxon country, of course, but it does not explain very well the financial development in our sample. And more importantly, the measure of investor protection is problematic, because we have found three different measures which give very different results. Another point which is important is the role of enforcement of contracts, which is always said that it's very important to protect investors, so to have a good enforcement of contracts, which find no impact on the development of venture capital or leverage buyouts. The level of protection of property rights is really important for VC, but not for buyouts, typically. And what is the main driver to explain the development of VC? It's not a surprise, it is the development of the stock market, so the level of financialization. Other important reverse, the protection of employment. Employment protection, which is always said to be very important to explain the development of investment. It is important for buyout, but not for VC, typically. So if you have a strong employment protection, the level of buyout investment will decrease, but it has no effect on venture capital. Another important driver for VC is public R&D. And it is quite clearly on all the regression that we made, we find that public R&D is a strong driver to explain the development of venture capital. And if we take the benchmark EBCA that we used to make this sample, we don't find a lot of variable used by the EBCA to justify the change of law that are significant. So we find only two variables which are significant. Which one is what they call fiscal R&D incentives, that is to say, does it exist a tax rate that supports innovation and R&D in some countries, typically? And Another which she called insurance, that is to say, from, does it exist a rule to allow insurance companies to invest in private equity markets? These variables are significant, all the other not. But what is strange, fiscal R&D incentives have a negative impact on the development of VC. So this is probably a substitution effect, and not this is not what we are expected in the literature. Last point, we try to compare the taxonomy from the legal origin theory and the variety of capital land theory, and the economic power of legal origins is less important than from variety of capital land theory. So I will finish on this conclusion. So, first point, the relevance of the EBCA benchmark to support the change of regulation has to be raised, because we don't find a lot of variables which are significant, and most of the time not with a good sign to the regulation. Moreover, one of the most important variables, investor protection, which is used in the Laporta works, is not always significant to explain the financial development. And the measure itself is very problematic, because it's found recently a database from another database, which gives that France, for example, has a higher investor protection than US. So which is not, it is totally the opposite of what you can expect, because US is an Anglo-Saxon country, so you can expect to have higher investor protection. That's not the case in this file. More generally, one problem with all this theory is to explain the institutional change. If you are explaining the development of the sector, yes, I stop, with a very static point of view, which is the legal origin, you cannot expect, you cannot explain a change. Okay, it's very difficult. You have a lot of patterns. I finish on policy issue. I think the main point to say is the role of public expenditure in research and development, and I know that Paul Nightingale will talk about that after, and to raise the question of industrial policy to develop industry. Thank you very much.